St. Louis, Missouri. The Savas Center has been our home away from home all weekend long. It's the site of the 2005 NCAA Wrestling Championships. We have already seen one weight class in the books, Joe Dubuque. He's the winner in the 125-pound weight class. And when you look at the team standings, Oklahoma State, they won in a rout. The Cowboys so dominant in winning their third straight national title. Hi again, everyone. I'm Dave Armstrong. We have already seen one wrestling champion crowned here tonight. We have nine yet to go. But when you look at the team championship, Jeff Blatnick, it was a one-sided victory for Oklahoma State.
Yes, it was. It's a three-peat. Their third in a row, the first time they've been able to accomplish this since the mid-1950s. And since they've won this championship, Oklahoma State now has 33, the most in NCAA wrestling history. And of the 10 weight classes contested tonight, Oklahoma State has five finalists.
Boy, five out of the 10. That's really a dominant performance for these Cowboys. Tim Johnson put that in perspective for us.
Well, one record Oklahoma State doesn't have is most champions in a championship. That's five, held by Iowa. They've done it twice. But tonight, if Oklahoma State runs the table, they tie the record.
So Joe Dubuque already has one title in the books, the 133-pound weight class. That's coming up next. We'll have the 133-pounders when we return to the Savas Center in St. Louis.
Goodbye.
No, wait. Come back. Oh, please come back. I don't even know your name. How will I find you? Wait. Please wait.
Mademoiselle. Señorita.
I'm gonna make a huge dent in my yard work, but not my wallet.
You can do it now, but pay for it later, only at the Home Depot. Now through Wednesday, get no payments, no interest for 12 months on purchases of $2.99 or more with your Home Depot or Expo Consumer Credit Card. Don't have one? Apply for it on the spot. It's in all departments, flooring, bath, even lawn and garden, and it's going on now.
The Home Depot. You can do it, we can help.
Want to save money on gas? How about 10%?
Huh?
How would you like a $25 Marathon cash card, too? Get the Marathon Platinum MasterCard from Chase and receive a 10% rebate. That's about 18 cents a gallon. Plus, you get that $25 Marathon cash card. Here's an application.
Sure.
Thanks. I gotta go. I need it on pump 5.
The marriage was built to last.
You are so awesome.
But the house was built too small.
This is kind of awesome.
How long are we here?
For 1 year, sparks will fly.
This is not awesome.
I just want to make an omelet.
Oh, are you kidding me?
The drama will be real, but it won't save you any money on car insurance.
GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Why haven't you called GEICO?
Thanks for calling Domino's. Three people? Everyone wants something different. Oh, it's okay, sir. We get this all the time. That's why we've got our 5-5-5 deal. Three pizzas, $5 each. Yeah, it is a great deal. You're very welcome. I love you, too.
Domino's 5-5-5 deal is back. Buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas, and they're all just $5 each. Only from Domino's. Get the door. It's the 5-5-5 deal.
We welcome you back to the Savas Center in St. Louis. In case you missed the 125-pound weight class, we'll show you just a few highlights of Joe Dubuque beating Kyle Ott.
Right here, one of the secrets was Dubuque getting out. I mean, that's where he started the run of the victory.
And the other was he was able to stop Ott's shot and ride him down. Grinder kind of performance, but very effective.
He picked up and put him down well.
The number five seed, Joe Dubuque, is your champion in the 125-pound weight class. So now we're ready for 133, and the seeds have prevailed. Travis Lee of Cornell, the top seed, against the number two seed, Sean Bunch of Edinburgh. Travis Lee will be wearing the red ankle band. Sean Bunch will be in the green ankle band. These two competitors are raring to go head on. And Travis Lee, right now you'd have to figure would be the favorite because he won the 03 championship at 125 pounds.
But you said it well, Dave. They've gone head on twice and they've split. The only loss Lee has this year is to Bunch, 11-10, so it should be a good one.
So we're all set to go at 133 pounds. And you're looking at Sean Bunch of Edinburgh. Kid by way of Leavenworth, Kansas, and Travis Lee of Cornell. He has an interesting journey, doesn't he? Travis Lee,
the first All-American from Hawaii in Division I. And he's the first Ivy League wrestler to earn All-American honors four times. Cornell's had a good tournament, and right now they're in fourth place. So this could catapult them up at least one place into third place if Lee would win.
Cornell with two wrestlers in our championships tonight. Tyler Bear will be wrestling in the 184-pound weight class later tonight.
Lee, a very skilled technician on his feet, very good at takedowns, Bunch extremely quick. If a person hesitates with his shot, he can turn the corner, spin behind in a heartbeat. And as I look at the conditioning of the two, Lee tends to start slow, and Bunch tends to fade late.
Boy, that was close, because that was a nice shot by Bunch. He didn't jump that by much.
Gives you an idea of the quickness that Bunch has, and he uses it very well in his style of wrestling.
Another shot. David Frisch is our referee for this match.
Trace.
A lot of energy here, lots of motion by both athletes.
Couple things going for them both. It's Sean Bunch's 22nd birthday today. And then I look at the high school that Travis Lee came from. He came from St. Louis High School in Honolulu, Hawaii.
There you go.
So, they both got things going for them tonight.
Bunch trying outside double leg shots. With no tie, no real setup, just trying to use his quickness. Lee doing a nice job of countering, but you can see Bunch with his right hand controlling Lee's left elbow, and that keeps Lee from spinning behind.
Lee should just be yanking that elbow out there. There he goes. He's around. Now you have to pick him up, put him down, and there. What a big takedown. I agree with you, Jeff. Travis Lee, who usually starts slow, if he can get out of the first period, you know, ahead or close, he's usually in good shape.
Down.
That was a real nice job of lifting and right then away, putting 51, Bunch back 51. Down on the mat.
You're still, take him. Out.
Second one, okay? It's your second one. Next one's a point, okay? Relax. Come on.
David Frisch warning Sean Bunch that he started early, and that's not the first time. That's the second. Next time it's going to cost him a point.
Get him! Game!
With the escape there.
Bunch did a nice job of getting to his feet. Exploded on the start. He didn't sit there and wait to see what Lee was going to do. He got up to his feet, good hand control, hips out, and got that point.
You want to lower your hips, walk away, and that usually breaks the lock of your opponent.
To assist you, the viewer, in which wrestler is which, on our little graphic there, you'll see Lee number 15. One. That means he's the top seed in this weight class, and the fact that it is in red, that signifies his ankle band color. Bunch, the number two seed in this weight class, he is wearing the green ankle band. We'll also try to identify them by their school colors. That's the singlet they wear.
Green choice.
Let's go to Quint Kestnick with an interesting story on Sean Bunch and a homecoming welcome with his sister.
Dave, Sean had a surprise visitor to the Savas Center last night. His sister, Shante, who's a first lieutenant in the Army stationed in Iraq, flew in for the championship. Sean has not seen his sister, Shante, in over a year. Also add that today is Sean's 22nd birthday.
What a great job right there. Bunch gets his feet under him and then his hips out. Hip heist out and gets the point again. Nice job right off the whistle.
And good hand control. Lee never got his hands locked.
So now this match deadlocked again at two. It's like starting all over again. A little bit of riding time, but not really a factor at this point. Only 24 seconds for Travis Lee.
Now it becomes the takedown game. Nice ankle pick by Lee. Switches off to a single leg.
And there it is.
That's the secret. Right there. He goes in on the single leg and immediately slides over to the other leg. Then when he misses that leg and it's not getting it from that side, he drops back to the near leg again and completes the takedown.
And it shows you the versatility of the attack, that in mid-stride he can change directions.
Watch his knee. Watch his knee.
That riding time starting to build now for Lee.
Good pressure by Lee on top there with the leg in. Keeping Bunch flat.
His coach is urging him to get more time. They mean more riding time.
And the leg's in again and again. Bunch goes down flat.
And that's what Lee's doing. He's doing a good job because the bottom man here, Bunch, keeps losing his base because you got to keep your hips under you. There he gets up.
So the escape worth 1 point makes it 4-3 in favor of Lee, the top seed.
Pretty late in the period to cut him.
3-2-1. So we get ready for the third period. We remind you that we're going to see 10 weight classes in all. We've already seen one, the 125-pound weight class. It all culminates with the heavyweights. And each match consisting of three periods, starting with a three-minute period and then two consecutive two-minute periods. And when you add up the total score after those three periods, that determines your champion. If we're tied at the end of three periods, we go into what we call a one-minute sudden victory period. Any points scored there, that results in a victory for that. If we're still tied after that 1 minute, then two 30-second overtimes.
Lee did a really nice job there getting out when he did, because I'm sure Sean Bunch wanted to ride and bring down the riding time below a minute. But Lee kept separating his hips away, creating space there, got his hips underneath him and got away. Sean Bunch just could not keep his hips close enough to keep Lee down. Nice job by Lee.
Bunch again with a double leg attempt from way outside, trying to use his quickness, but Lee able to counter effectively.
And guys, the significance of Lee being able to escape so early too, he saves his riding time.
Exactly right.
This time he's in on Lee. Oh, but Lee with a fabulous job of countering, no points.
Wow. That's like picking up 2 points, really, isn't it?
That kind of a great defense, you bet. Bunch had an opportunity to score. Lee denied him. It's as good as 2 points in the bank.
So instead of it being 5-5 and all tied up, now Bunch, he is still the underdog. And remember that riding time at 116. Now he can raise that if he can get a takedown here and then ride things out for a while.
Stay center, stay center.
The only problem is there's not a full while left in this match right now.
He's got to go now. He knows it.
Bunch is going straight on. You don't go straight on against Lee. You've got his quickness has got to be able to get him to the outside and find the corner. He has not been able to do that. Lee is just too strong, squared up, and he gets him two.
That might be difficult. I thought I heard the whistle. Right.
You blew the whistle. Yeah. Did you think it hurt him on defending his takedown?
It probably did. Yeah, it might have.
They're going to wait.
I blew the whistle.
You blew the whistle.
Yes. Blew my whistle. You're neutral.
Lee has no problem with that. Here we go.
He can back up more now. He hasn't been warned for stalling. He's got time on his side. And with a front headlock, all he has to do is hang there.
5 seconds to his second championship. Travis Lee, a two-time champion.
Leg bands, gentlemen.
Lee, the winner in 2003 at 125 pounds, now the 2005 champion at 133.
Good job. Congratulations.
So Travis Lee, he's in the winner's circle. Travis Lee from Cornell is a champion in the 133-pound weight class.
Want to bounce back fast from tough pain? Get the only leading brand with real liquid inside. Advil Liquid Gels. Faster and stronger than extra strength Tylenol on tough pain. Advil Liquid Gels rush relief right where you need it. Advil Liquid Gels. Liquid fast. Advil strong.
Inside every can of Minwax is the secret to enhancing wood's natural beauty. Minwax rich wood stains and long-lasting protective finishes make it easy to turn any house into a beautiful home. Minwax makes and keeps wood beautiful.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot!
Yeah! Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, no, this time start with Right Guard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. Right Guard, start right and right.
Is your shampoo missing something? Head & Shoulders is missing nothing. Its penetrating formula helps eliminate dryness, itchiness, irritation, and flakes. It's complete care for your hair and scalp. Head & Shoulders.
Hammer throw is tough. It isn't just you against a 9-pound ball. It's you against yourself. It's pure concentration, and you have to dig deep inside to find every throw. It's brutal. I had to study biomedical engineering just to relax.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
It's like a miracle. I cannot believe it, you know. People, they don't even recognize me.
Propylene, scientifically proven to reduce weight. So powerful it works by itself. Backed by 11 independent clinical studies.
You don't change your life. All you do is take a pill. And the fat just comes off.
It definitely works by itself. Because I knew I didn't do anything different. And I took it and I lost weight.
Try it. Eat the same way. Do what you're doing. And this pill will work.
Every morning when I look at myself in the mirror, I see another person there.
Call now to try Propylene risk-free for 30 days for only $29.95. If you don't see amazing weight loss results, send it back and we'll refund your $29.95. But wait, it gets better. Call now and we'll include a second bottle absolutely free. Call in the next 10 minutes and your shipping and handling is also free. That's right. Call now and your second bottle and shipping is free. That's an additional $40 value. Yours free when you call right now.
We welcome you back to the Savas Center in St. Louis, ready now for the 141-pound final. This will be an all Big 12 final. Top two seeds prevailing, Nate Gallick of Iowa State and Teon Ware of Oklahoma. These two certainly no strangers to one another. In fact, they have met each other four times, and Nate Gallick has come out on top all four times. When you look at Gallick of Iowa State, the junior, the number one seed, unbeaten this year at 29-0. Ware, when you look at him, his two losses, both of them to Nate Gallick. So we welcome you back inside with Nate Gallick of Iowa State. That's Teon Ware of Oklahoma. Both of them wearing a version of red anyway. Gallick will be in the red ankle band. Teon Ware in the green ankle band. That's Nate Gallick right there, the top seed. How much pressure, guys, on Gallick? I mean, he has never lost to Teon Ware ever. He certainly doesn't want to start now.
No, he doesn't. And what Teon has, he may have four losses to Nate Gallick, but he has an NCAA championship to his credit. He's been here. He's been in the spotlight, and he's won it. So Nate Gallick, this is what he's been pointing towards all year. He's undefeated, and this is, if he doesn't win, it's a failure of a year for him as far as he's concerned.
The last time they met, it was 4-3 during the tiebreaker, so the last one was real close. Ware has been putting up bunches of points in this tournament.
Yeah, he has really been impressive. I mean, he hasn't just been winning. He has been winning by major decision all the way through this championship.
Let's do this. Shake hands, fellas. Ready.
Mike Haggerty is our referee for this match.
Stop it! Stop it!
There won't be any feeling out process. These guys know each other well.
Both juniors, they've been wrestling each other, as we said, wrestled four times over their career. Deion Ware winning the NCAA championships as a freshman.
Gallick, in talking about Ware, said, well, this will be our fifth time. He is really hard to wrestle.
You're talking about Ware piling up the points. One thing I've seen about Nate Gallick is he wins the hard matches. He wins close matches. He always seems to come out on top. Those 29 wins, there are a lot of close matches in there. He's always on top.
And that's a big advantage experience-wise, having the confidence to stay close and remain effective, knowing you can do it. He's been there a bunch of times. Shot by Gallick, countered well by Ware. See that circular motion, so effective, is trying to turn the corner.
Work through there, guys.
They're both looking to wrap a leg when they're doing that.
Beat the arm. The arm's going to reach out to try to hook the leg to stop you from spinning behind. The object's to keep the head down. Try to hook the backside of your opponent, keep the weight forward, keeping his head down, and that way you can turn the corner.
It's all about changing levels. You got to change levels to have effective offense. So you got to change your level, have an explosive shot. Boom, boom, boom. Keep your feet going.
Shot to the face.
Let's keep it easy. You want to dump it off or put it in? Make it quick. You want to go dump it off? Go dump it off.
Let's look at it again.
I just let him go. Here
quick
we go,
shot
guys.
To the face, inadvertent. And Nate Gallick couldn't get the contact back in time, so he's just dump it off. Get rid of it. So he's virtually wrestling with one eye right now.
I like the hand slap when he returned to the center. Good show of sportsmanship by both athletes. It was unintentional.
Work through it. Let's go.
Teyon Ware, homegrown, four-time Oklahoma State
Same
champion.
Same thing, guys, both
up. Jason University of Oklahoma.
Ready.
Nate Gallick out of Arizona, wrestling for Bobby Douglas at Iowa State.
Pop your hips under.
See if he goes for an ankle pick off of that. Nope. Ware able to break the lock.
Action. Stalemate. Let's go, guys. Come on. That's you guys. On the lines. We can get through it. Ready. Lines. On the line.
Little Nicks are starting to catch up with Gallick. Now he's got something wrong with his finger. No takedowns yet, no points, no riding time. We're over 2 minutes into this opening period.
Elbow up, elbow up. Take it, that's it, stutter on that. Stutter on that.
Put them together.
Elbow up, stutter and go.
Snap and shut.
Stutter.
Stop,
Here Coach Spates of Oklahoma in the background saying stutter, give that fake after he snaps the head. Try to use two setups instead of just one.
That's exactly what he's talking about, is keeping the motion going all the time. You know, to be offensive, you got to be looking for the action all the time.
On the lines, hold it, guys. Is that your hand? Where's that coming from, T?
There's some blood on the mat. So we'll go clean that up, and I think it's coming from Gallick's finger. So they're going to attend to that right now.
Yeah.
And maybe a little bit on Teyon Ware's forehead as well. Let's go to Quint Kestnick. Quint?
Dave, Teyon Ware credits his success this year to an adjustment that he made in his style during the offseason. His coach, Jack Spates, said, you got to work on your offense. You're a great defensive wrestler, but you have to come out and take it to them. The scouting report really got out last year. After he won the national title. He lost five matches last year. Ware said that other guys were just going to sit and wait and try to make something happen at the end. Teyon said, I have to find an offense to complement my defense.
Well, and as Jeff pointed out, he's been much more offensive in this championship.
Oh, we're good. Thank
okay,
you.
Guys.
A little blood coming from the nose of Teyon Ware. They've got all that cleaned up, and the mat cleaned up as well, with 13 seconds remaining in this opening period.
Gallick, an All-American last year, finished fifth. Teyon, All-American his freshman and sophomore year. This is his third time.
Choice is red. That's you. The third
first, green.
So now Nate Gallick has the choice. And the choices are what?
To defer or to choose what you want, on top, on bottom, or neutral. He deferred, he gave Teyon Ware his choice. Now Teyon chooses down.
So there are four choices, really. Top, bottom, neutral, or defer.
And tactically, that gives Gallick the choice later in the mat to fit the situation he finds himself in.
Do most now choose the defer choice? I know it's something new to NCAA wrestling. Are most choosing that option?
Unless you're behind and you need to get on the board and you want to go underneath and score right away. But on a 0-0 match, yes, you want to defer.
Well, Nate Gallick is the number one seed. He is wearing the red ankle band and the red singlet with the Iowa State on the front. Teyon Ware, the Oklahoma singlet with the green ankle band. He is the number two seed here in 141 pounds.
Both wrestlers doing a nice job there. Nate Gallick, very tough on top. But Teyon Ware coming up, getting his feet underneath him, almost getting his hips underneath him, but then Gallick driving through again. They go off the mat.
Do you see any edge for either one of these guys yet?
At this point, I see it all even. There's really nothing that's separating them. Neither one has really found an opening in the opponent's defense. This is where the first points probably will get scored, is if Ware can get away. Break it down.
Trying to get over that magical 1 minute. Ware trying to escape, and he does. That's 1 point for Ware.
That was a great job of continuous motion by Ware. He kept his feet underneath him, got his hips out, created space, and got the one.
And the balance to be able to keep your back leaning like that. You're only on your heels. You're leaning on your opponent. He was able to do that, break the lock, turn to face.
And another shot to the face. And that same eye where Gallick lost his contact.
You hear the word chop it there from the coaches. It means come down on your opponent's arm. If he's leaning on you, that'll cause him to lose his balance momentarily, maybe create an opening for an attack. There's a great shot by Ware.
And 2 points for the takedown.
The edge you were talking about and asking about, David, just goes to Teyon Ware right there. That takedown, that's a big point spread now, 3-0. It's just as important right now for Gallick to get at least one in the last 20 seconds.
And this is going to really be big in terms of the strategy of the match. If Ware can ride him here, it's huge.
What's huge here is the start. Here's the takedown by Teyon. Look at level change into the single. Drops down to both ankles, two.
Real quick.
And now Nate Gallick has a timeout here to look at a finger. Remember, that finger had been bothering him earlier, and I don't know if they're just going to tape it or exactly what, but he keeps looking down at it. It's on that hand. You can just see it on the ring finger of that left hand, blood coming out of that fingernail. They just need to clip off the fingernail. Getting rather graphic here, and then we'll see if the bleeding can stop or they'll just tape that up.
Well, this is a huge 13 seconds when they come back to the mat. I mean, you know, to beat the best, and that's what we have out here, to beat the best, you can't be ridden. And right now, I think a key to Nate Gallick is being able to get out in this 13 seconds to really being in the match.
It's either going to be 3-0 or 3-1. You're within tying distance if it's 3-1 with a takedown in the third period, or you have to get away. 3-0, you have to get away. It's huge in terms of the strategy of the match.
Remember, Gallick deferred, so he'll have the option to start period number three, and I'm sure his option will be determined whether he can escape or not.
Got to his feet right away because he hit hand control.
Great explosion. Oh, nice job by Ware to drop down because he hasn't been called for stalling. Very smart.
There's no hanging on here. Now he needs to move up, but great job by Ware.
So Ware maintains his 3-0 lead. And now the option is for Nate Gallick. What do you think he'll do?
He's going to choose down. He has to. He's got to be able to be in a position to score as many points as possible. This gives him the first opportunity to score one. And then, like Jeff said, he's within tying distance. He escapes, then he takes him down to tie. I really think he's going to have to escape and take him down twice maybe to win this match. Ware in a good situation here.
Step the head! Step the head!
You're not going to escape with your head on the mat, though.
Trying to get to his feet.
Ware so quick. Gallic seemed to be away, but Ware able to hang on. And he returns him.
Boy, that was a great move by Tion Ware, the 2003 champion.
And there was an effective tactic. He turned Gallic inbounds, not letting him get out and get a fresh start.
Well, if you've never seen someone that just knows how to be at his very best when it counts most, you're looking at it right now. Tion Ware, this is what you call, he's got the want to right now. He wants this championship. He knows what it's like to win one, and he knows where he's at right now.
Wow, stall call against Ware for just riding, not getting out to the side looking for a pinning combination. I think Ware at this point, with 3 seconds shy of riding time, is going to hold him down for a little bit and then may cut him.
What's the strategy there, Jeff? Why would you cut him?
Simply because you don't want to pick up a stall call, and Gallic gets away 1 second shy of riding time.
How about that? That was key.
And it was key because Gallic changed the strategy there. He went right to a sit out right there. Crossed over, got out, got his hips away.
Gallic inviting Ware back out to the center of the mat.
One more time and he'll get the stall call.
And that's a smart tactic.
One
it puts
more time.
The onus on Ware. Everybody's looking at Ware not coming back to the center.
He's got a little blood. He's got to spit out.
And a little blood from the nose.
Well, look at this. You could tell he wasn't going to stand up because his head was there. Boom! Crosses over, gets out. A little shit out there. Hip heist out. He'd been standing up. Tion Ware had been a great job of picking him up and putting him back down. Changed tactics, boom. With 1 second to spare. What a great move.
And great adjustment.
He's going to get called.
That's pushing there by Gallic. Gallic's not letting him into the center. That's not wrestling. That's just pushing. Wow, and he got hit for stalling by the referee.
Now a takedown by Gallic will put him ahead. 20 seconds left. It comes down to this.
Can he get called for another one?
Yes, he can.
He certainly can, and these referees won't hesitate. If they feel he's stalling, they'll hit him. He needs to return to the center. That's a good hold for Ware right there.
He did a great job of doing it.
And he'll hold on for the championship.
A repeat backflip from 2 years ago. There's your winner, Tion Ware. First time he's ever beaten Nate Gallic, and he did it when it counted.
Nate Gallic collecting his thoughts, wondering in their fifth matchup how he could lose to Tion Ware, but Ware literally able to hang on to the very end and become the champion at the 141-pound weight class, his second championship after losing out last year. He is a return champion from 2003 and again here tonight in 2005. So Nate Gallic, the top seed, couldn't get it done. Tion Ware of Oklahoma is your champion at 141 pounds.
Last week on Dream Job.
I was surprised and disappointed.
J.R. Reed been cut.
Next week, things heat up.
I thought you improved. You did good. You did good. He slam dunk tonight.
And your vote will help decide the final two. Dream Job, live Sunday night at 10.
That is a great jacket. Ooh, I have to have one.
fun.
I love how they've updated it. Salsa is so in right now.
And I love the hint of lime.
Hey, they're totally checking us out.
Only Taco Bell's Fiesta Taco Salad takes classic ingredients and updates them with a tangy, chunky salsa and crunchy lime seasoned tortilla strips made right when you order it.
Looking good.
For a great tasting taco salad.
Thanks.
Think outside the bun. Spice up the night. Open till midnight or later.
One car has factory installed keyless remote start, and it's not a Honda Accord. Only one car has the first and largest four-panel panoramic roof available, and it's not a Toyota Camry. And it's not a Nissan Altima 2.5 that has the most powerful engine. It's the first ever Pontiac G6. With action, anything is possible.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Visit ChoiceHotels.com this spring and book a stay at any of these hotels. You'll earn triple Choice Privileges points or triple airline miles. Triple your rewards only at ChoiceHotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
A wash and a wax used to take a lot out of you. But with the new Armor All Gel system, you can wash without a bucket and wax while you dry. Every time. The Armor All Gel system. The simple way to get a wax with every wash.
Championship continues through April 5th on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
Sunday, ABC and ESPN has two NBA basketball games. First at 3 Eastern on ABC, the race for the playoff position heats up. Tim Duncan leads San Antonio against the Detroit Pistons in a potential finals preview, while the first-place Suns take on the surprising Grizzlies. Check local listings for the game in your area. Then at 7:30 Eastern, Tracy McGrady, Yao Ming, and the Houston Rockets face Kevin Garnett and the Minnesota Timberwolves. The NBA on ABC and ESPN. Oklahoma State so dominant this year in winning their third straight national title and their 33rd overall. Tonight's Home Depot coaching clinic features Oklahoma State head coach John Smith, and he gives us an overview on one of wrestling's most essential moves.
The guys that are scoring takedowns are usually the guys that are winning matches. So it's very important in college wrestling. And all you're doing is taking your man from his feet, getting behind him, and controlling him. A simple takedown, obviously, is a double leg. Okay, our opponent hits his double leg, takes his opponent to the mat. He turns. That's a two takedown. That's a very important technique in college wrestling, as well as very important to score those type of points.
And the Oklahoma State crowd revving things up here at the Savas Center because they're seeing their first wrestler, Zach Esposito, the top seed in the 149-pound weight class, all set to take on Philip Simpson of Army. These two, Simpson a senior, Esposito a junior, they met when Esposito was just a freshman. So the top two seeds prevail. Well, Zach Esposito trying to get the job done here, guys, after a runner-up finish last year.
And that is interesting. 2 years ago, they met here in the NCAA tournament with Simpson defeating Esposito 9-4 in the wrestlebacks.
And that knocked Esposito out of the tournament there. He didn't place. The following year, they both moved up. Esposito here to 49, Simpson to 57. Esposito second, Simpson eighth, and now Simpson cut down to 49. They meet again.
This is Simpson's third weight class that he's wrestled in his career. He's a senior, Esposito Jr.
Esposito wearing the orange singlet of the Oklahoma State Cowboys. You'll see that five times tonight. And, of course, as the number one seed, he is wearing the red ankle bands and a takedown here for two.
Esposito draws first blood. Simpson now must try to get away.
This is the first time to the finals for Simpson of Army. Three-time All-American, 29-1 this year.
Esposito, one of three Blair Academy alumni in the finals. He, Mark Perry at 165, and Steve Mocco at heavyweight, all from that great wrestling program at Blair Academy.
That's in New Jersey. One of the best schools. Most coaches look there for recruiting talent.
Esposito not only with a takedown, but building riding time. You saw earlier, up to 50 seconds of riding time here in his opening period.
You see how Esposito comes up. He doesn't stay on his knees. He comes up to his toes a lot. Look at, he keeps his weight off his knees. That keeps more pressure on Simpson. A lot of weight on Simpson. And Simpson doing a nice job of getting up. But, oh, nice job
nice
here.
Roll. Whoa,
but look at Esposito, because he won't stay on his knees, he keeps his hips on top. Good job of riding.
You always want your opponent to carry your weight. If you put your knees down, you're taking weight off of him. And it's been a long time since Army has had a national champion. 1963, Mike Natvig, the last to come from West Point.
Simpson twice now, we've seen him just basically crawl for that out of bounds area so he can get a restart and see if he can do something about it. There's your note, Mike Natvig, back in 63.
Good job. Almost a spiral ride here by Esposito. Getting out to the side, not chopping the arm, but trying to drive it forward.
He's built up a minute and 50 seconds of riding time. My goodness, what an advantage.
Good call, David. Hey, you got to work off the hip a little bit, all right? Too much parallel. Okay, go. You're down.
David Hickson is our referee for this match. John go. Smith says, we're all right.
It's a great explanation there. Parallel ride. You're staying in line with the opponent, not getting way out to the side.
Got 20 seconds. 20.
Over 2 minutes of riding time.
Center up, guys.
What's interesting here is Army's coach, Chuck Barbie, is a former OSU wrestler. And so he gets an opportunity to bring something very special. There's Chuck on the right-hand side there to the Army over his former teammate.
Important to keep him down here, not let him out in the closing seconds. It's just critical.
And he will. As we go to Quint Kesnick on the sideline. Quint.
Last night after a semifinal win over Michigan's Eric Tannenbaum, I asked Zach about his relationship with John Smith. He said he's like a father and a brother. When you're out there on the mat and you look over, you know he's been there. His advice is always right on. Esposito said Smith is part leader, part teacher, part mentor. Said he's like a brother, but most importantly, he's my friend.
In case you were wondering what happened there, Esposito cut Simpson. He let him go and he was trying to fake it going at his legs, but Simpson, very calm, just walked away from him. He has to be able to turn and face.
Why would he cut him there? Why would he let him go? He's already built up a lot of riding time.
That, and he doesn't want to draw another stalling call.
Quint's comment about Coach Smith, part this, part that, part this. I think that's the beauty and the brilliancy of Coach Smith's rise to having Oklahoma State back on top, because coming in from total wrestler, it took him a while to come to this point as total coach, and he has become that. He's done so well is he's allowed to have his wrestlers, and you're looking at Coach Smith right there, he allows his wrestlers to grow in their giftedness. If they're a thrower, they throw. If they're good at low singles, he says hit it.
And Simpson just did. A nice low single. Look at the knee of Esposito. The referee will keep an eye on that.
No! Doing the splits now.
You saw that in the semifinal match by Esposito. Did a total split to counter a single leg attack. Esposito has an ankle of Simpson in the air as well. This could end in a stalemate.
Breaks, stalemate! Good hold, good hold, good hold! Good hold!
Simpson had a wonderful opportunity there. Couldn't get it done.
Esposito saying losing last year in the finals has served as a year-long motivation. He started to prepare the day he got back to Stillwater for this year's final.
Okay, offense from here. Let's go. Come on, guys. Wrestle.
Well, that's, again, the mindset and the influence
20,
of John Smith.
20.
Come on, improve the tie-up. Let's go.
John Smith,
both
anytime he ever had a loss, and there
guys,
weren't many, I'm sure his preparation for the next year started the day after.
One of the things that John Smith did with his Oklahoma State team is they were so dominant for so long, and then they went through that probation period when he first took over, and he said, guys, we can't always just assume we're the favorite anymore. Let's take on the role of the underdog. And for John Smith, that was really saying something, because he said, I never was an underdog when I wrestled, and to take on that role for my team, that was really doing something. But he said it was what we needed to do to get the hunger back, to get the desire to be champions again. And here they are now, three-time defending national champions and 33 overall national championships for Oklahoma State. Esposito with a 2-1 lead. Plus, remember, 2 minutes and 16 seconds of riding time. It's going down some here in this third and final period. But remember, he just needs to keep it over 1 minute. Anything over 1 minute, he gets that extra bonus point.
Good pressure by Esposito to turn and face and try to kick his right ankle free. There he's able to do it and turn the corner.
And a 2-point.
Simpson allowed too much hip separation right there, and therefore Esposito was able to slip around. Nice job by Esposito.
This puts Esposito firmly in control score-wise now. Simpson down, needs to try to get away, come back with the takedown, but with the riding time up there, he still trails. Stall call may come into play here. Esposito's already been warned.
Serve, guys. Center up.
Let's look at the reversal again.
Right here. He comes across. There's the hip separation right there because he's able to slip it around. Grabs back ankle to establish himself and then cross faces. Steps over the ankle. Gets the two.
Under 1 minute to go in the 149-pound championship.
No,
Zach Esposito, the first of five Oklahoma State wrestlers we'll see tonight.
So if Simpson can improve here, he tried to turn and face Esposito. But what a remarkable job that Esposito does in maintaining control.
He'll get the point for the riding time, no doubt about that.
Got 20.
You don't get 3 points for going over 3 minutes. It's just 1 point. Anything 1 minute or above doesn't really matter. It's just 1 point for riding time. He can smell it now, and so can that orange-clad cowboy crowd.
Fred, go! Red, good, one!
Zach Esposito. And his coach, John Smith, they'll hug. Esposito's been working his whole life for this moment.
Pat Smith, John Smith's brother, the assistant coach, the first ever four-time NCAA champion in the corner two, the Smith brothers.
Let it out, son, let it out. And the way John Smith is thinking, that's one down, four to go. So Zach Esposito, your champion at 149 pounds. Just imagine one solid year of planning for this moment and then to have it come to fruition. Zach Esposito, that's just pure joy. Uninhibited joy for Zach Esposito. Well done. So the Cowboys are on the board with their first champion. Earlier today, we saw in the 125-pound weight class, Joe Dubuque of Indiana, the number 5 seed, able to get by Kyle Ott of Illinois and win at 125 pounds. And at 133 pounds, it was top-seeded Travis Lee, who won at 125 pounds in 2003. This time, he wins at 133.
Even with good credit, getting a home loan can be a long process. But at eLoan, you apply in just minutes, either online or over the phone. There's a lot less paperwork, and you get a loan decision fast. It's lending the way it was meant to be. Apply now at eLoan.com.
Later on, LeBron James is here, and we'll have this, something like that. Let's just run through it. Yeah. Okay. No, I think it's sold out, actually. Let me just start like that. Whoa! Are you guys rolling on this?
Yeah. That's a 90-footer. Oh,
that is amazing! Oh, my! Did you get that? You have that, right?
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot! Yeah!
Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, this time start with Right Guard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. Right Guard, start right and right.
Arlen Judd.
When someone's got it in for you.
I'm on my way.
When someone's getting over on you.
He suspects I'm being poisoned.
When there's no place else to turn.
My best friend, he stole $100 million.
They're watching out for you.
That money is mine.
Dave, ow.
We got him.
Bring it home.
Tim Daly.
Hi.
Eyes, they're watching out for you. Premieres March 30th, 10, 9 Central, only on ABC.
The champion, Jeff Jarrett. The challenger, Diamond Dallas Page. Two ring warriors battle for the NWA Heavyweight Championship.
To become the world heavyweight champion is my destiny.
It's my destiny to end your legacy.
Plus, the most incredible match ever devised in professional wrestling. Ultimate X. TNA Wrestling presents Destination X.
Homeowners, listen up. See this number? Write it down. If you're like me and tired of paying up to 18% interest on your credit card, call Countrywide Home Loan. I did, and they offered me a home equity line of credit at a great rate. That's how I paid off my credit cards. That's how I'm saving over $500 a month. There's the number. Pick up the phone. No one can do what Countrywide can.
Call now, 1-800-641-7298.
We welcome you back to the Savas Center in St. Louis for the 2005 NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships. And we're ready now for the 157-pound weight class and a real Cinderella story. We're taking you back to quarterfinal action. Joe Johnston all the way to the finals, and in the quarterfinals, he was able to beat top-seeded Alex Tirapelli and then Jake Percival, the number 5 seed, yesterday. And here is how he did it.
Right here, Joe Johnston just kept the pressure on Alex Tirapelli, who likes to scramble, but right here, Joe Johnston wins with the scramble.
And signaling that joy to the Iowa faithful. And then in the semifinals.
Just a relentless attack on the legs against Percival. Joe Johnston, a real goer, never lets up.
So now he is in the finals, and we'll take a look at tonight's Coca-Cola storyline. Coke in the NCAA, nothing like it. And you can see that Tirapelli's not the only number one seed not in the final. There are four in all. We already saw Sam Hayswinkle. He dropped out in the semifinals. Letters and Trenge also losing out and losing their hope of being national champions. So now we're all set for this great matchup, the all-Big Ten matchup here, the 157-pound weight class. Joe Johnston, the Cinderella story, the number 8 seed. Brian Bertin, the number 2 seed out of Michigan.
He's going to have to keep it up, Johnston, as far as his Cinderella story, because he's never beaten Bertin, who's already won an NCAA title as a sophomore 2 years ago. They've met 4 times, all Bertin.
4-time All-American Bertin is of Michigan. Johnston, this is his first time as an All-American.
Johnston saying he changed his mentality a little bit. He said, I'm being a little stingier instead of leaving myself wide open. Johnston with the red ankle band, Bertin with the green.
Bertin likes a single to his opponent's right leg. Johnston likes the double shot, puts his head on the left hip of his opponent. Difference in those shots, the single, the head's on the inside, the double, the head's on the outside.
Ryan Bertin, the 2003 champion, he says he gets tunnel vision during a tournament. I stay away from the arena. I come in when it's time to wrestle, and that's it. He said, I don't want to burn up energy watching someone else.
And you tend to do that. When you watch wrestling, you start to look at it and say, is that right? Is that wrong? What would I do? It's good to stay focused on your own match.
Already, Johnston establishing himself here with the being able to fend off the attack by Bertin. Three shots by Bertin, his favorite shots. To the right leg twice, a little attempt at the fireman's carry. All three times, Joe Johnston, it was like he was a half a second ahead of him.
Joe Johnston, guys, was quoted as saying, I really felt anything was possible. It's a matter of me wrestling my match with my pace and my holds. What does he mean by his pace?
Well, you want to dictate how quick the match is traveling. You know, are you going to just stand there or are you going to move around a lot? And Iowa's history has always been lots of motion, move forward, wear your opponent down. A beautiful single leg. Head on the outside there, he's trying to finish. No points yet, he's got a turn though. He's got his right leg hooked up for Keane's leg. But Bertin's got Johnston's ankle. I don't know if Johnston can improve here. Bertin working up now.
Continue working.
If Bertin can't get his head up, in which he's starting to get up. So when you get your head up, you have a chance to score. So now Bertin's coming into a situation where Johnston is in big danger. He's got the Granby finish right there.
Peterson end of a roll. He's got the arm in the near leg. No back points, but he does get the reversal.
Johnston does a nice job of keeping from getting the back points in that Granby finish that Bertin was able to get the two on.
Good call, Jimmy.
So Bertin takes the 2-0 advantage. That's quite a reversal for Bertin because it was Johnston who grabbed his leg first.
Are you
it was.
Set?
Johnston had a great
cover
attack. Bertin, an excellent counter. And boy, did he take his time feeling his way through that pressure to earn that reversal.
Well, usually the wrestler that heads above the other one is the one in the better position. And at one time, Bertin was down and Johnston up, and it looked like Johnston's advantage. But as Bertin got his hips underneath him, got his head going up, he was in better shape and he came out with the two.
Jim Ramirez is our referee for this match. He says that's a stalemate. They're not going anywhere. They'll restart.
Set. Cover.
Bertin building up a little riding time here in this opening period. It's up to 40 seconds.
Johnston may face here. Yes, he does.
Well, Johnston gets that point on the reversal, or on the escape, excuse me.
3, 2, 1.
And the first period comes to a close as we send you to Quint Kesnick. Quint?
Dave, when we sat down with Ryan Bertin last night, the feeling was one of relief. He's a senior with one more match. Says he's been healthy for the first time in a long time, and he's having the most fun he's had in 18 years of wrestling. He said his first title was for himself, but if I win tonight, he said, this is for my mom and dad. Family, a huge theme here this weekend.
Yeah, family is a common denominator, common theme for so many of these young men. And they rely so much on their family for their support and the dedication they have to the sport. And so many times we've seen not just one member of a family involved, but more. And there's an escape for Bertin. So he's up 3-1. We have, what, 7 brothers in this and some sets of twins as well.
3 sets of twins as well. It's always been a family affair. Usually with the younger ones being the better ones because they learn from the older. Yeah.
They got beat up when they were little.
You can tell from this match that Joe Johnston wants to be right here. He rode long enough to get the riding time down a bit, but he wants to be on his feet. Here we go again in a scramble situation, and Bertin being able to come up. He's got Johnston down on his hips in a bad position for the Iowa wrestler.
Want to put weight to the head here. Johnston wants to keep the weight towards Bertin's head. And you see Bertin trying to back out and circle around Johnston's leg.
Two more points for Bertin, building it up now to a 5-1 advantage. And now rebuilding some more riding time.
Very deliberate pace by Bertin, very confident in what he's trying to do.
This is patented Bertin ride right here, which Johnson's almost able to reverse. He likes this kind of match, a 3-4 point lead. Gets up in the crotch right there on his ride. And really, you know, it's... Until the official sees it, it's a good ride. But, I mean, he's just stalling right in there is what he's doing.
Coming in, guys, this 157-pound weight class, we all just went, wow, what a weight class.
Cover, Tom Mann.
Certainly was with the caliber of athletes that were in there, former national champions and finalists. Very difficult. Johnston, the big surprise. Bertin reestablishing what he did 2 years ago. Johnston kicks out.
Johnston can't allow the shots by Bertin. There, he's got to dictate the action.
And the second period comes to a close with Bertin leading 5-2. The Division I Women's Swing and Diving Championships are Friday afternoon, March 25th at 2 Eastern on ESPN2. For a preview of the Women's Championships, visit NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships.
Dropping right to the leg like that might get a stall call real quick for Johnston against Bertin.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to get Bertin called, but it doesn't seem to get him called as he does it. That's how he rides.
Very interesting, dropping to the leg like that.
Said in this weight class that as many as 8 guys could win it, and that's proven true here for the number 8 seed making it to the finals. Interesting that seeds 1, 3, and 4 did not place.
Come in! Sit down, let's go. Open up, gentlemen.
Warned for stalling.
Again, Bertin, the number 2 seed with the green ankle band. Johnston, number 8 seed with the red ankle band.
Johnston wants to circle inbounds. If Bertin drives forward, he can get out. Now there's the escape point.
We're going up.
Right back in this match now. He needs a takedown. Remember, riding time, though, a factor. Minute 43 of riding time for Bertin.
Yeah, in effect, he needs to take him down, let him up, and take him down again to be back in this match. Force even overtime here. Bertin does a great job of making the shot. It was really Johnston's turn to shoot there. Bertin turns the tables on him, shoots. Very great strategy. He gets a 2.
Once he grabs that other leg, that's the 2, right?
Yeah.
So there's once he's flat and you show control, and when you hook both legs and down like that and your opponent isn't grabbing you, that's definitely a takedown. And that's a great, as you said, Tim, tactic. Why sit there and try to play defense? Why play defense? Why not use what's already been a proven offense and the ability to take your opponent down to ice the match?
Are you set? Cover.
Getting close to midnight for the Cinderella, Joe Johnston.
Right there, that should be stalling on Bertin. Johnston doing a nice job. There it is.
1 point, a stall tactic for Bertin.
But the thing is, he could take it. He could take a stalling call. He could take another one. This is about winning a championship.
Masterful job by Bertin.
It would have made it interesting
But there's the time. Even with that takedown, Whiting Tide would have won it for Bertin. And he's your champion.
So Ryan Bertin, the champion in 2003, champion again here in 2005. Three times now we've seen him win, not once, but twice. And we still have a couple of more chances, and we have a chance even at a three-time champion here tonight. So Ryan Bertin of the University of Michigan gets his congratulations. The tunnel vision for Bertin paying off as he wins at 157 pounds, destroying the dreams of the Cinderella story, Joe Johnston, in the process.
NCAA Women's Basketball Championship continues through April 5th on ESPN.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. On travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
This spring, you don't have to go far to make travel rewarding. Just visit choicehotels.com and book a stay at any of these hotels. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline miles.
I've been everywhere.
Your rewards only at choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
Even with good credit, getting a home loan can be a long process. But at eLoan, you apply in just minutes, either online or over the phone. There's a lot less paperwork, and you get a loan decision fast. It's lending the way it was meant to be. Apply now at eLoan.com.
Try Boston Market's new seasonal special, featuring the bold flavors of spicy Tuscan rotisserie chicken with penne marinara and spinach with garlic butter sauce. Or try crispy baked country chicken with mashed potatoes and creamy country gravy. Boston Market, we're always cooking.
Good morning. At GEICO, we're all about happy customers. In fact, our customer satisfaction is at 97%. But to get the other 3%, my friend and I are going door to door across America.
So the witch said, come here, my pretty little darlings, and look at my small car insurance bill. That slays me. We're on our way to 100% satisfaction.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
There are two sides to me. The all-conference catcher side, that's my tough side. And the side of me studying for a career in marine mammal rescue, that's my soft side. I'm finding I really need both sides to be the whole person that I want to be.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
And we welcome you back to the Savas Center in St. Louis, Missouri, for the 2005 NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships. The nation's top bowlers hit the lane Sunday afternoon as ESPN's coverage of PBA bowling rolls on with the finals of the Banquet Open. This is the last event on the PBA Tour's regular season schedule. The pressure's on to win and become exempt for next year. The PBA Tour on ESPN, Sunday at 12:30 Eastern. So Oklahoma State, they've already wrapped up the team championship, their third straight national title, and their 33rd overall. When we come back, 165 pounds.
It's been a wild day here at the United Way Draft. Next up is the blood drive.
We select Antoine Randall L.
This is interesting because it means a position switch for Randall L. He's excelled for the can drive as a collector, but the blood drive plans to use him in a registration role. Antoine Randall L. giving everything he's got, including a few pints of O positive, to the city of Pittsburgh.
Get involved in your community. It's what matters.
There are millions surfing the web with net zero for less than 10 bucks a month. Are you one of them? If not, then it's time to switch to the internet service that ranks higher than AOL in customer satisfaction. Join the millions. Switch to net zero. Go to netzero.com.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahani.
What a lovely shot!
Yeah! Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, no, this time start with Right Guard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. Right Guard. Start right and right.
Last week on Dream Job.
He's shooting under 40%. It was very intense. Number one, they got D. Brown on their team.
The competition was tough. And one player had to go.
I was surprised and disappointed.
I need more analysis out of you.
I thought it was bad, man. I ain't gonna lie to you.
J.R. Reed, been cut.
Next week, things heat up.
I thought you improved. You did good. You did good.
He slammed dunk tonight.
And your vote will help decide the final two. Dream Job, live Sunday night at 10 on ESPN.
It's like a miracle. I cannot believe it, you know. People, they don't even recognize me.
Propylene, scientifically proven to reduce weight. So powerful it works by itself. Backed by 11 independent clinical studies.
You don't change your life. All you do is take a pill. And the fat just comes off.
It definitely works by itself. Because I knew I didn't do anything different. And I took it and I lost weight.
Try it. Eat the same way. Do what you're doing. And this pill will work.
Every morning when I look at myself in the mirror, I see another person there.
Call now to try Propylene risk-free for 30 days for only $29.95. If you don't see amazing weight loss results, send it back and we'll refund your $29.95. But wait, it gets better. Call now and we'll include a second bottle absolutely free. Call in the next 10 minutes and your shipping and handling is also free. That's right. Call now and your second bottle and shipping is free. That's an additional $40 value. Yours free when you call right now.
The 165-pound weight class is just underway. Johnny Hendricks of Oklahoma State against Mark Perry of Iowa. Hendricks has just scored on a takedown. He leads 2-0 with less than 30 seconds to go in the opening period.
Well, what an interesting match. Mark Perry, who you see in the Iowa uniform, is John and Pat Smith's nephew. His brother are John and Pat, the head coach and assistant coach's sister, but he's not an OSU singlet, Jeff.
Talk about an in-law relationship, so to speak, there.
And the first period comes to a close. A somewhat controversial takedown here.
It's not so much the takedown that's a controversial, it's that they think right here, this low single looks so much like John Smith, and he gets the call. But it's a matter of just staying down on that ankle that they thought he was stalling, and they never called him for it.
Get on, Red.
Mark Perry, the only freshman in the finals here tonight. He was able to get to the finals by beating top-seeded Troy Letters of Lehigh. Letters had been unbeaten this year.
Hendricks looking for an inside cradle.
Stanley! Good job. Green down!
Tom Galen is our referee for this match.
Let's go.
Hendricks in the orange singlet with the red ankle bands. Mark Perry in black with the green ankle band.
Ooh.
Nope, good.
Earlier this year, these two met, one at the UNO Open and then down in Stillwater in the big dual meet between Iowa and Oklahoma State, where Mark Perry grew up in Stillwater before he went to Blair Academy to high school. And it was a very close 3-2 loss for Perry. Sure, it stung to come back to Stillwater and get beat by his uncle's team, but he has the opportunity here to reverse it. But Johnny Hendricks on top, 2-0, and gaining a lot of riding time.
That riding time is up over 2 minutes now for Johnny Hendricks.
And Esposito clearly out to the side, trying to work the arm.
Get on that point. Hey, keep going.
Putting a lot of pressure on Perry here.
Keep it legal. Keep it in line. He's keeping on the body. Right. Watch on. Good job. Green down, right up. 35.
Check green.
John Smith with 35. Five wrestlers in the championship. One has already been victorious. Zach Esposito at 149 pounds.
Get on, Red.
This for Iowa, their second and last competitor in these finals.
The one thing about Perry, very few people can do what he just did. He is really funky. Mark Perry, he's got great control of his body. But right now, Johnny Hendricks answering that.
15.
Hendricks might want to duck this leg with his head.
And Mark Perry not letting him.
Love the split crowd. You see the standing and applauding by the Cowboy fans, and on the other side of the arena, the Hawkeye fans are booing.
Well, and maybe not just the Hawkeye fans, maybe all the other fans. Oh, when OSU's out in front as much as they are, it seems like everybody else is rooting against them.
What do you want? Now Johnny Hendricks goes into the third and final period with not only a 2-0 lead, but 3 minutes of riding time.
Hold! Get on, Green!
So riding time will be a factor. Really 3-0 for Hendricks. Now Perry.
Hendricks trying to turn the face here to get an escape.
Go Green!
Perry keeps behind him.
Great job by Perry staying behind the arm.
But red down, green up. Break clean. Hey, when I blow the whistle, you break clean.
Hendricks beat the second-seeded Ryan Shirella.
Set.
Of University of Michigan. Shirella had one 33 in a row coming into that match.
Watch for Perry to try to suck him back and throw a half Nelson in like he just tried there, but Hendricks waiting for it. Grabbing the head now, trying to turn and get a reversal.
And that was all from the start. Hendricks exploded. He had his hips underneath him. He put the back pressure in. That all came from his start off the whistle from the bottom. Great job by Hendricks.
Jeff, you said he was waiting for it. Might that be a little bit of scouting, too, on the part of the Cowboys?
Without question. You have coaches scouting. They know each other. They've seen each other before, so they knew what Perry might have up his sleeve. Plus, Perry tipped his hand when he did it in the semifinals.
Whatever you want, Tom. Whatever you want.
There's the Granby to hook the ankle by Perry, and now it'll be a scramble again.
Still red! Work to improve! Ho, ho, ho! Break clean. 36, Tom, 36.
Hendricks can now taste it. He's only 36 seconds away from the championship.
Get on, Red.
Did it again. This time he has Hendricks in trouble.
That's right. There's two reversals. He's got to know what he needs to do right now.
Both of he's working. Let's go. Yeah.
He'll try to pull Hendricks back and put his legs in.
Good. Good job.
You can't
go
forward.
Okay. Red down, green up.
Coach Zaleski wants Perry to cut him.
Set, Red.
Remember the riding time for Hendricks. He'll get a point there.
Get on, Green. Bottom end!
Watch me, guys. Watch
me. Tom.
Gary Green,
Tom,
get on.
Tom. One more second.
Hold up.
One second.
Hold up.
18. Should be 18. And you got to take the riding time 1 second back.
Riding time 1 second. You get the riding time too?
Okay.
All right,
let's go.
That's Bob Durr, who is the alternate official for this match.
Get on, Green.
Perry needs a three back points. That's 15. Really the only way he's going to get back in this match.
Keep working, guys. Don't come forward. Sideways and backwards. Keep working.
Oklahoma State trying to go 2 for 2.
1 point.
And they
break
will.
Break clean.
Johnny Hendricks. John Smith right now is getting more hugs than he would at a family reunion. Johnny Hendricks joins his teammate, Zach Esposito, in the winner's circle. So the Cowboys smiling as they go 2 for 2. Johnny Hendricks is your champion at 165 pounds. And the Cowboys are saying, we're not done just yet. Chris Pendleton, the top seed, and the 174s. He's up on the mat next.
When you're a star like me, you get treated differently. This is my ID. Look at this. They've even taken the shells off for me.
Even my independent insurance agent spoils me.
John, with drive insurance from Progressive, I can customize a policy for your car, motorcycle, RV, even your boat.
You are embarrassing me.
Actually, I do it for everyone.
Yeah, I get it.
Everyone gets taken care of with drive insurance from Progressive.
How long have you two been together?
Teresa counts from the first day that we met.
And I count from the first...
Wow. Ashton Kutcher.
He's about ready to pop a blood vessel in his head.
Bernie Mac.
You want to force me to use the muscle? Ooh.
This Friday.
I'm not going to back down.
Let the battle begin. Guess who?
These eyes, they see everything.
Take it off.
You take it off.
Rated PG-13. Everywhere Friday.
Thanks for calling Domino's. Three people? Everyone wants something different. Oh, it's okay, sir. We get this all the time. That's why we've got our 5-5-5 deal. Three pizzas, $5 each.
Yeah, it is a great deal. You're very welcome. I love you, too.
Domino's 5-5-5 deal is back. Buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas, and they're all just $5 each. Only from Domino's. Get the door. It's the 5-5-5 deal.
I'm going to make a huge dent in my yard work, but not my wallet.
You can do it now, but pay for it later, only at the Home Depot. Now through Wednesday, get no payments, no interest for 12 months on purchases of $299 or more with your Home Depot or Expo consumer credit card. Don't have one? Apply for it on the spot. It's in all departments, flooring, bath, even lawn and garden, and it's going on now.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
The Players Championship on ESPN. The Games Pass compete for the biggest payday on tour. Tiger, Lefty, Vijay, and the Big Easy. Then there's number 17, beautiful and intimidating. The signature hole at Sawgrass where no lead is safe.
Uh-oh, that will find the water.
The championship could be won or lost right here. The Players Championship. Coverage begins Thursday at 11:30 a.m. Eastern on ESPN.
And we welcome you back to the Savas Center in St. Louis, Missouri for the 2005 NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships. We'll go back to a couple of weight classes, starting with 141 pounds. What happened here, Tim?
Teyon Ware turns the tables after four losses to Nate Galley, wins the championship because he attacked him and got that first takedown.
Then at 149 pounds, the parade starts of Cowboys.
Well, Esposito lost in the finals last year, but this year, in control, really took it to Simpson, able to take him down and earn the national title.
Hey, great job.
And when you look at all the champions so far here today, Joe Dubuque of Indiana at 125 pounds, Travis Lee, his second championship from Cornell. He won an earlier championship in 2003 at 125 pounds, this time at 133. Teyon Ware with a championship at 141, and then Zach Esposito. Ryan Bertine of Michigan able to win at 157, and we just saw Johnny Hendricks of Oklahoma State. Now, speaking of the Cowboys, we go to the 174-pound weight class, and the top two seeds are both from the Big 12 Conference. Chris Pendleton of Oklahoma State and Ben Askren of Missouri. These two guys are no strangers to one another. When you look at the overall matchup this year, both losses for Ben Askren have come at the hands of Chris Pendleton. He is the number one seed. They have met eight times in all, and Pendleton with the big edge, he has won seven of those eight meetings.
Well, they both think alike because I know they want to just both win the national championship. Chris Pendleton winning it last year. Askren saying, you know what?
Go on in, shake hands.
If I lose this match, the whole year's a failure.
One thing Pendleton knows, and he said this, he admitted it. He said, Ben's one of the few guys who I feel has my number. If I don't show up, he's proven he can put me on my back. He did that at last year's Big 12 championship, the only win for Askren. And then Askren followed and said, yeah, but Pendleton got me when it really counted in last year's final. So it's Pendleton, the top seed in the orange Oklahoma State singlet. Ben Askren and the gold of Missouri. Pendleton is wearing the red ankle bands and Askren in green.
That won't be the last time you see that scramble and that kind of pretzel outcome.
We've seen a lot of that, Tim, throughout this tournament. It's almost like a new technology of defense. The roly-poly, diving in between your legs, grabbing your opponent's ankles and counter. And Askren is a master at it here. Pendleton stepping over, trying to put Askren on his back. See if Askren can convert on the ankle of Pendleton.
Twisting of these limbs, it's amazing that cartilage isn't separated with moves like this.
Pendleton's left arm is hooking over the top of Askren's right arm. That's called a wizard, and that is the defense that is enabling Pendleton here to keep Askren from scoring.
Askren doing a nice job, again, finding the angle to come back to that position when Pendleton almost came out and faced him. He just got to get up to his feet, get his hips up in the air. Now catch that far ankle. He kind of let him go there. Where I think with the new rules, if he would have jumped at it, kept his feet in bounds, he could have gotten two.
Honey Marks.
Each wrestler with a good attack thus far, but neither could convert to earn points.
Gary Kessel is our referee for this match.
These guys do a little different styling. As you see how far their hips are out, their butts are out in the air right there. It's hard to attack when they're that far and they still have good position.
There it is. He's got the far ankle.
Had the far ankle and he also slipped the wizard. Nice job. Pendleton getting 2 points.
Pendleton won last year's final against Askren by the score of 11-4.
Easy off. Break easy.
Credit to both these wrestlers. We've seen how many upsets have happened. Defending champions go down. Those that were in the finals last year not getting back. Here they are. The number one and two seeds in the finals where they're supposed to be. Sometimes we give all the accolades to those low seeds who upset, forgetting how much pressure it is on the top seeds to go where they're supposed to be. We have the example right here.
That's a good point. Tim, what I love is Askren's confidence. Even though he's lost 7 out of 8 meetings against Pendleton, he says, I didn't come here to make the finals. I came here to win.
That's exactly right. He's lost only twice during the year, and it's both been to Pendleton. He says, hey, it doesn't matter because the only goal I have is to win the NCAA title.
Green, you have all the options, Green. Green will defer.
Let's go to Quinn Kestning. Quinn?
Dave, I asked Coach Smith what he has enjoyed most of having Chris Pendleton in his program. He says he's loved watching him develop. He's never been around an athlete who's developed so rapidly. Came into the program as a 145-pound high school senior, wrestles 174 now. Says his improvement is across the board, physically, emotionally, and technically. He's identified his weaknesses and always moved forward.
You know, one of the reasons there, that's a great point, is because Chris Pendleton didn't start wrestling until late in his middle school, junior high years. I talked to him about it. He got beat a whole lot of times as a freshman. He is fresh compared to a lot of the wrestlers that have been wrestling since 5 or 6 years old. So he has a lot of upside to him, and that's what you're seeing now in his development.
Good shot by Pendleton, and on the right leg of Askren. Oh, what a great move there. Elevating the leg, forcing the takedown.
Building up a commanding 5-0 lead, and riding time now starting to become a factor. That's up to 55 seconds.
Lots of time left in this match. Don't count Askren out. He's unorthodox and has the ability to put people on their back.
As Quinn was talking about moving up in weight classes, we take another look at this great move.
Did a nice job of controlling the hips. He was in on the single, and then he attacked the hips and put him down on the mat.
Great reaction by John Smith as well. when you were thinking of moving up in weight class, how difficult is that for these guys? Is it a natural progression for them?
Ashton could get the reversal. He does. It's difficult at times to move up in weights. Bigger power, but you have your speed and your technique. As long as your technique doesn't slow down, you can compete with them.
And sometimes it's just because you're a late bloomer. Your body is changing as a freshman and sophomore. And I think that's obviously part of what happened with Chris Pendleton. Pendleton answered that reversal with an escape of his own. Scores 6-2 as the second period winds down.
So this second period comes to a close. Pendleton has the advantage, 6-2. The Division I Women's Swimming and Diving Championships coming up Friday afternoon, March 25th at 2 Eastern on ESPN2. For a preview of the Women's Championships, visit NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships. Pendleton, the number one seed. Askren, number two. And the riding time, he continues to build.
And with the elbows out there, that makes it easy to go in and get the wrist, and that's what Pendleton's done. He first has the hips of Askren down on the mat, then the hips get up and his elbows are out, so he goes in and gets the wrist and pulls them in. Great job of riding, taking advantage of what Askren's given him.
Is that a technique Askren needs to work on as he gets a little older?
Well, you got to keep your elbows in. You're just offering the near wrist to you, and you know, you're right. You can always get better.
Oh, here, Askren trying to make a move here. Pendleton struggling, but Askren able to turn the corner and come out on top.
Stop! We got a reversal. Front injury time, red.
Something wrong with the left arm or shoulder of Chris Pendleton. They haven't stopped the clock yet. It's still running. Somebody needs to stop the clock.
That's the injury time.
They've
got a minute 15 left in injury, and if he's not able to go, then there was nothing illegal about it. Askren would win by default.
And there, that arm got twisted. And Pendleton, now that 58, they're counting down. That's the injury time. That's how much time he has remaining.
He's got to make a decision on whether or not he can go.
Wow. Boy, when you look at last year, this is a rematch of last year's final between these
same
two
competitors.
Red,
you tell me when you're
ready. This is what happened a year ago in 174-pound weight class between these two. And again, it was a dominant performance by Pendleton, and he won easily by the score of 11-4, beating the freshman. And here, Pendleton is, he says he's ready to go, and we're back to action here tonight.
Askren just let Pendleton go, cut him, so now Pendleton ahead 7-4 with riding time. There's got to be a big move here by Askren.
Oh, yeah. Pendleton looking at a cradle, but I don't think he's got the angle to effectively use it, so he'll hang on to the ankle and earn the takedown.
Yeah, and he hung on to the ankle, then he cut across to the other hip, other side of the hip. Nice job of adjusting and getting his 2 points.
Threat of the cradle, though, really put Askren in a bind. He had to give up, really, defending the leg.
One! We're neutral, guys. In the center.
That shoulder feeling a lot better for Pendleton now. He knows he's just 15 seconds away from defending his championship.
He can give up points. He hasn't been hit for stalling. He can back up. It's going to be tough for Askren to come back here.
And the Cowboys go 3-for-3.
Good job, guys. Hey, Dr. Angleton here.
John Smith's Cowboys are so dominant in this championship.
Do you think Askren's going to look forward to next year without Pendleton?
I was wondering, was he congratulating him or saying, thank God you're leaving?
Yeah, I was going to say, congratulations on graduating. Eight out of nine times.
174-pound weight class left now to Ben Askren, and that sophomore is primed to take over. But Chris Pendleton, the fourth two-time champion we have crowned here tonight. Chris Pendleton of Oklahoma State makes it 3-for-3 for the Cowboys.
How many days of spring break?
21.
Won't you miss your room?
A little bit.
Won't you miss Rocky?
You know what I'm gonna miss the most?
What?
This face.
Why not take all of me? Can't you?
Mr. Buckley, welcome to Residence Inn.
I'm no good without you.
Residence Inn. All suites with all the comforts.
If you have great credit, shouldn't you get a better rate on your home equity line? At eLoan, you do. We process your loan differently, online. That costs less, so you get a great rate with no lender fees. Apply today at eLoan.com.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot!
Yeah! Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, no, this time start with Right Guard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. Right Guard, start right and right.
The echo in the gym. The squeak of the shoes. The buzzer. The brick. The whistle. The crowd. Swish. I left the game, but it'll never leave me.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
Homeowners, listen up. See this number? Write it down. If you're like me and tired of paying up to 18% interest on your credit cards, call Countrywide Home Loans. I did, and they offered me a home equity line of credit at a great rate. That's how I paid off my credit cards. That's how I'm saving over $500 a month. There's the number. Pick up the phone. No one can do what Countrywide can.
Call now, 1-800-641-7298.
Playing this month on Dish Network Pay-Per-View.
They're not hunting us. We're in the middle of a war.
Alien versus Predator.
You raised our son.
So I never had a kid.
I remember!
They're listening.
The Forgotten. Take a break from routine TV. Order a movie from Dish Network Pay-Per-View.
This was after he won at 174 pounds, jumping up into the stands and hugging his mom, Lisa Pendleton. Congratulations to Chris Pendleton as he and mom share this warm and glorious moment. Now we're ready for 184 pounds in a division that has absolutely been dominated by our number one seed, Greg Jones of West Virginia. He has blown through this competition, and he awaits Tyler Bear of Cornell, who comes in as the number seven seed. But when you look at Greg Jones, you are looking at one of the greatest wrestlers in NCAA history.
Going for his third NCAA title, very rare club to be able to join, but how about this? He's only given up 10 takedowns in his entire career and scored over 400.
That's amazing.
He won as a freshman and then had an undefeated regular season as a sophomore and came in and lost 2 out of 3 and didn't even place. He said his mindset changed from them. He came into the NCAAs before to win. From then on, he said, I came to the NCAAs to dominate. That's the only way to continue winning the championship. And that's what he's done since that moment on. He goes up to 184 pounds as a junior, and he has never lost at that weight.
Greg Jones, the number one seed in the blue singlet from West Virginia and the green ankle bands. Tyler Bear all in red. Red singlet, red ankle bands. And the number seven seed for Bear. Interesting, guys. Jones, who won as a freshman, as you mentioned, Tim. And right after, he was getting congratulated by his assistant coach, Zeke Jones. Zeke said to him, you know what? The only thing better than winning one NCAA title? Do it 2, 3, or 4 times. And he said, that's when I knew the bar was really raised and I had to set new goals.
Well, I love that comment because that's what his secret of success has been, to set new goals. He said, I went and wrestled some world-class wrestlers, and that humbled me. So I know just because I'm the best here doesn't mean I'm the best in the world, so I've got a ways to go.
Well, when he won as a freshman in New York, it was when Cale Sanderson won his fourth, and what a great example to follow. We were all talking, can you imagine if he does win four? He's got the one loss as a freshman. He's been undefeated his next 3 years during the regular season. Everybody thought, can you imagine having only one loss and you're second in the wrestling history books?
The only disappointment for him is sophomore year here at these NCAA championships. He had a great season, but then it was all for naught as he lost two out of three matches here at the NCAA championships as a sophomore. And since then, it's just been all Greg Jones. He grew up, his dad, Vertus Jones, actually coached the neighborhood kids down in the basement. They just threw some mats down there, and Greg says, what I remember most is it was really small and it was really hot.
Brother Vertus, actually a two-time All-American for West Virginia, and a final, a three-time All-American, a finalist, finishing second as his best place finish in the tournament.
This is the first year as an All-American for Tyler Bear, the number seven seed, coming all the way through, being in the finals, a senior.
Good call.
His third NCAA tournament appearance. He's
yes,
up from 174 last year to 184. Cornell having a great tournament.
Great.
Going to go home with a trophy.
45.
And if Bear off can win, that could propel Cornell into second place. And they'd lock it. There's no one that could advance past them.
Now, Cornell, no matter how you slice it, guys, they've had an amazing run here at the NCAA championships. And they've made sort of a statement that, you know what, Cornell wrestling is here and it's here to stay.
I agree with you. They picked up five-time New York State champion Nickerson as a top recruit, and they have others as well. So this program's on the rise.
15.
That's Coach Rob Cole, NCAA champion at North Carolina, now the coach of the Big Red.
They are able to escape a possible takedown there, and now a warning. Keith Pullman is our referee for this match.
Jones's speed is what separates himself from the rest of the pack. He has the ability from the outside to get in tight to the hips, control the hips, and get the takedowns.
Jones leads 2-1 after period number one. We go to Quint Kestner for the report from the sideline.
Down. Jeff, you just hit it on the head. The name of the game for Jones is his speed. When I talked to him yesterday, he said, the biggest thing I want to do today is wrestle with a lot of energy. If I have a high pace, I can do well. He says he's better off when he over-wrestles rather than under-wrestles, and he's learned his lesson in the past. He says he's prepared for an opponent with a 2-19 record as he is in the NCAA Finals.
He gets the escape here and leads 3-1.
Jones comes into this match with a 50-match winning streak, looking to close his career with 51 straight wins.
Amazing. I want to go back to something you said earlier, Jeff, and I don't want to just make it as an aside. This guy has had more than 400 takedowns and has only been taken down 10 times. That's just a dominant performance by him. In fact, they said one time he took an opponent down so hard the opponent's shoes stayed on the mat.
Well, in the three finals he has been in, he's had 11 takedowns, never been taken down.
Takedown, nothing. Thank you, right
there. And now he's got the takedown. And opens up a 5-1 lead.
Add another to that list.
Yeah.
Bear is game, though.
Bear, I mean, as you mentioned, Tim, just an amazing run for him to get to this finals, to upset the number two seed Kurt Backus.
Neutral.
And then also upset the number three seed Travis Pasco.
Always been dictated by Jones.
He gets off first.
He really does put you back on your heels, doesn't he?
The great thing is if you try to close the distance and lean on him, he's able to pull your arms to his side or establish some kind of circling motion and creating angle, and he does it with the quick feet.
You know, what's happening here is what happens every time an opponent somebody wrestles Jones. He looks bad. I mean, Jones makes you look bad. He's so dominant, but it's a very defensive dominant as well as his offense. I mean, he's dominant in his physique. He's dominant with his position, and it just makes you look bad.
He's had trouble with that headgear, though.
4 seconds. Set.
4 seconds left in this second period, and it comes to a close with Greg Jones leading 5-2.
Red down.
Riding time not a factor, only 10 seconds of riding time right now for Jones. He's going to let him go.
Yeah, that's 3 points for Bear, but all the...
Blooming whistle.
That was Gawney.
But all the points have been given to him by Jones.
Like a cat just prowling his opponent.
There, now finally Bear gets off of some of his own offense, got Jones
center
to react. I think Bear wants contact before he shoots. At least he knows where Jones is and where his hips are. When Jones is outside, no contact. It's hard for Bear to even get close.
Well, a lot of people have found Jones' hips. They know where they're at. They get to them, but they never get through them. And that's what you have to do to execute offensively, is to not just get through the hips, but through them. And very few people get through that third line of defense of Jones. Look at that. Caught him coming in.
Got both ankles, 1 foot still in bounds.
Still neutral.
Ooh. You saw Greg Jones, a little fist pump there, like, oh, almost. Just ran out of real estate. Less than a minute to go for the third championship for
45.
Greg Jones. He'll join an elite group of three-time champions.
I mean, when they go ear-to-ear like this favors Jones in a big way. He's just a stronger wrestler, more dominant from a physical standpoint.
Still neutral, center.
And it doesn't help Bear at all.
Little exclamation mark there by Jones, knocking Bear over while they went out of bounds. Bear has to have some desperation now if he expects to defeat Jones at all. Takedown will not the score.
15 seconds.
Great hip defense by Jones, because Bear was there. But Jones didn't let him come any further. You know, he had that shot, but you can't stop and then get squared up. You got to find that angle, that corner, and come around, and that's what's been happening to Bear. And that's what happens to everybody against Jones. You get stopped and squared up.
Only 3 seconds now for Greg Jones to win his third title in 4 years. And that will do it. Greg Jones is your champion at 184. He caps off a great career.
One of the greatest ever. Congratulations to Coach Craig Turnbull of West Virginia, assistant Zeke Jones.
So Greg Jones able to win at 184, as many predicted. He was dominant. So that advice he got as a freshman, don't stop at one. He took it, and he ran with it for 3 national titles.
Thanks for calling Domino's. 3 people? Everyone wants something different. Oh, it's okay, sir. We get this all the time. That's why we've got our 5-5-5 deal. 3 pizzas, $5 each. Yeah, it is a great deal. You're very welcome. I love you too.
Domino's 555 deal is back. Buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas and they're all just $5 each. Only from Domino's. Get the door. It's the 555 deal.
People all over are waking up to a new kind of performance sedan. This is the first ever Pontiac G6. And things are a lot different in here. With action, anything is possible.
Later on, LeBron James is here, and we'll have this, you know, something like that. Let's just run through it. Yeah, yeah, okay. No, I think it's sold out, actually. Let me just start like that. Whoa! Are you guys rolling on this?
Yeah.
That's a 90-footer. That is amazing. Oh, my. Did you get that? You have that, right?
Being an actress is torture on my hair and scalp. Torture.
Dryness, itchiness, irritation, not to mention 100% of flakes are a thing of the past with one surprising shampoo. Head and Shoulders. Your hair and scalp get complete care. Today's Head and Shoulders.
Inside every can of Minwax is the secret to enhancing wood's natural beauty. Minwax rich wood stains and long-lasting protective finishes make it easy to turn any house into a beautiful home. Minwax makes and keeps wood beautiful.
Championship continues through April 5th on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
Welcome back to the Savas Center in St. Louis for the 2005 NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships. We head now to 197 pounds. We have a 2-seed against a 5-seed. Sean Stender of Northern Iowa with an upset over John Trenge in the finals yesterday with Stender the senior and the Rochald only a junior. He is a defending champion. He won in 2003. So Jake Rochald, the fourth cowboy to take center stage. The other three have all come away champions. Can he make it 4-for-4? Rochald in the orange singlet. He is wearing the red ankle bands. And Sean Stender of Northern Iowa is his opponent in black along with that green ankle band.
A couple of three-time All-Americans here. Rochald, of course, an NCAA champion 2 years ago as a freshman, was third last year as a sophomore. Stender was fourth 2 years ago as a sophomore, sixth last year, and first time in the finals.
These two have met once. Rochald won 6-2.
Amazing, though, for Sean Stender as you're looking at just a little bit of a cut on Jake Rochald. Sean Stender upsetting John Trenge, and that was really a big story here in the semifinals last night.
Yeah, I'd rather have you put the stick on there.
John Trenge having been in the finals twice in his career, looking to try to put an exclamation mark on his career by winning the NCAA title, and he doesn't get to the finals. And
he came back and took third here. But Trench lost to the great Cale Sanderson, then to Damian Hahn in a last-second takedown.
We're going to put a little extra on Jake Rochald's cut just to make sure that it doesn't continue to bleed. They put what they call the stick on it.
You know, it's kind of neat in that third-place match, Trench signified his retirement by leaving his shoes and his headgear on the mat, walked off. He's not going to compete anymore internationally at all because of that eye injury. He wanted to try to win the NCAA title, but it's over now. And there's Stender in on a shot, but nice hip action by a neck wrench by Rochald, but a nice roll through by Stender. 2 points.
Stender getting the added bonus of not only a few fans from Northern Iowa cheering, but Iowa State and Iowa both cheering on Stender.
Go over there. We need somebody to clean the mat, please.
That's a nice job by Stender there as his initial shot there, and then Rochald comes on, tries to take it with a neck wrench, but it was a roll through.
In a blood timeout, there is no accumulated injury time.
So now we're going to take another look at that two-point move by Sean Stender.
Stender in nice on the legs there. Rochelle goes ahead and counters him, but now he gets his hips under him, and Rochelle tries that neck wrench, but Stender rolls him through, earns the takedown.
Ready? Let's go!
Ready to go again. Our veteran official for this match is Fred Ambrose.
Dig in there, dig in that underhook, get out that underhook. There you go. Get away from that too!
You can see Stender's hips a little lower than Rochelle's. Not afraid to change level. He gets down nice and low for his shot on his opponent's
hips. Work the mat! Work the mat!
Rochelle doing a nice job of hand fighting.
Work in!
Tying up Stender's hands. Good shot by Rochelle. He finishes.
He retakes the lead. What an active first period for guys this heavy.
Stender's tapping the mat with his right hand. He might be hurt.
We got time here.
Excuse me? Stay in the corner. Stay in that
ribs, his ribs.
And this is injury time. They're counting down. He has just so much time.
I heard him say ribs left side.
Let's check it out again and see if we can see where he might have sustained the injury.
Nice shot by Rochelle. Head up, just drives him over sideways. Hard to see where that might have happened, but there was twisting.
Well, and you wonder if there wasn't a pre-existing
injury. Cody, make sure that's stopped here. Yes, they're working on it right now, boss.
Because it looks like just the twist right there. Something popped, cartilage maybe.
While this is going on, they're also making sure the cut of Jake Rochelle is being closed in the other corner.
Another look at this
40 seconds
situation there. Yeah,
time.
He turned in awful hard. That's probably that's when he tweaked part. It. He just got overpowered
we
by Rochelle.
We just waved it off to him. Then he has to stand up and get ready to wrestle.
That injury time is down to 30 seconds.
And you see him tap his hand there to let him know
stop
he was
the
hurt.
Crack. Okay, now wipe that blood off his face. This is my time. Come here. Come here over here. Stay right there. Wipe that blood off his face.
Stay in here, Hoss.
Talk, wipe the blood off. Okay, let's go. We're ready to go. Let's go. Let's go. We good? We're ready. Green's down. I want you back here. I want you back here. You're down here. You're facing that direction. You stay right there. I'll call you in. You're set. Red, you're top. Let's go now.
Well, for anyone that's ever had a rib injury, they're extremely painful. Oh, this could be dip. Oh, Rochelle's got a real good opportunity to put Stender on his back there. Stender counters through.
Oh, and he almost caught him with the headlock coming through, but he countered through very nicely, kept himself from getting the 2 point back points against him.
Watch that arm.
Stender just saved himself a couple of points and maybe a possible fall.
Let's work.
You see that riding time starting to build under a minute to go, first period.
45.
Bar arm by Rochelle. See if he can use it to be the tilt, run around the head and turn him.
Down here, you're at top, let's go. Out of the circle, back him up. You're down face up. We need action now, we need action. Red, you're top, let's go now.
Love how the officials just keep the pace going. They really take command of these matches.
Yeah! Down here, red up.
Stender doing a good job of getting to his feet, getting his hips underneath him. Next thing, hand control. It can't be just one, two, three. It's got to be almost simultaneously, but they all have to happen. Feet underneath you, hips underneath you, hand control. But not head on the mat. You're not going anywhere with a head on the mat.
Now that riding time up over a minute in this first period.
Stender could use an escape here. 15 seconds left.
Down, green on the bottom. Down, green.
Well, you know, you don't endear yourself to the official when you have your head down on the mat. You gotta keep coming up. Back pressure. Keep
green
coming
choice
up.
Is green.
Look at coach.
Green defers.
Will defer to red.
Takes down. Red chooses down. There's also a star warning on green. Green top. Get out. Right here. Now take your time. Take your time. You want me to start with the hand? You watch the hand. Right here. Watch it. Go top. Go top. Easy. There you go. Run!
And an escape for Rochal. He takes a 4-2 lead. Reminder, you can see a repeat performance of the entire NCAA Division I Wrestling Championships on ESPN2 this coming Tuesday at 2:30 Eastern.
We'll show it with a front headlock, but out of bounds.
Come on, let's go today. Come on, ready? Drive!
I get it. Needs to pull it in.
Good hold.
Rochal can't flee the mat right here. Now, if Stender can come across and catch that ankle, Rochal doing a nice job getting his hips on top, keeping Stender's head down. See, with his head down and Rochal's hips up, that's advantage Rochal.
No control.
Just took himself out of a position of danger into position. The worst thing that could happen was the stalemate, and that was the best thing that could happen for Rochal right there by getting his hips on top of Stender and putting Stender's head down. Rochal is managing this match masterfully since being taken down early in the match.
What do you mean by managing it?
Well, he's dictating the pace.
35.
He's turned around the momentum that Stender had from the first takedown, and now he's doing everything he wants to do, getting the inside tie right there and not letting Stender shoot from open space where he got his first takedown.
And on top of that, he's also built up a minute 16 of riding time.
Oh, both shot at the same time. Stender now showing a little more offense.
We're working. We're still working here.
And as the second period comes to a close, advantage Jake Rochal to Oklahoma State.
Choice. Give me a choice. Give me a choice. Let's go. Neutral. Set.
Green chooses neutral.
I like that choice by Stender.
Would you go in the face again like that? You hear me? Right here. Let's go now.
Red Ambrose is trying to keep it all clean.
Watch those eyes.
Nice double again.
Good hold.
And Russell manages.
Get neutral.
What a tremendous job of hip action by Rochal to turn this thing back into his favor, because again, look where his hips are on top of Stender's head, and instead of just hanging on. Wow.
Oh, he just saved himself a couple of points right there.
Great shot by Stender. He got his open shot just the way he wanted, but he wasn't able to finish it off.
John Stender, the number 5 seed with a green ankle band. Jake Rochal, the number 2 seed, trying to become the 4th Cowboy to win a championship here.
Now you always want to take the weight away from the head on a double leg shot. Rochal kept the weight over the head, not letting Stender finish.
We're up neutral. Let's go center.
Stender needs another shot like that to get back in this match.
Area.
Plenty of time to wipe out riding time that Rochal now holds.
Well, he's not going to get it just shooting straight ahead. You got to move in a circle. You got to find the angles.
Let's go.
Then you keep the hips in and lift. His hips got away from him, and Rochal used his hips to square up Stender and keep him from getting the takedown.
45! Stop! now. You need time? Let's go. Right now. Set. There it is. Starting red.
There's a takedown.
He needs to cut him.
No, he wants to.
Yeah, you're right.
Keep him riding.
If he can ride him down, you're right, Jeff.
12 seconds.
If he can ride him to 12, well, if he can ride him out, he's got to ride him out.
Let's go.
That'd be the best tactic to do.
Center, you're done.
Got to keep him down. You can't let him go.
Riding time.
You're set.
He's got to erase that riding time. He needs to keep him down for at least 12 seconds, 13 seconds.
You can't let him go or he's going to get that escape point.
That's
so you got to keep him down.
And has he been called for stalling?
Yes. He got a point taken away for stalling.
He needs to come up. He needs to come up.
Got to come up. He's got to come up. Oh. He got rid of the riding time.
But he trails by one.
You saw Rocha looking up at the clock, too, to see how much time remains. And there it is.
Good fight, Haas.
The championship for Jake Rocha, the fourth cowboy to be crowned champion here tonight.
Stender had it in his grasp, literally, to go to overtime, and it got away from him.
So with 9 weight classifications, guys, in the books, 6 champions tonight have won not once, but twice, and in one case, 3 times. Repeat performances are more the norm than the exception here tonight. And Jake Rocha makes it 4-for-4 for the Cowboys and John Smith.
We see you getting the next big idea. We see 400 employees in 3 years. And new partnerships formed. We see ideas exchanged freely. At Microsoft, we stand in awe of you and your potential. It's what inspires us to create software that helps you reach it.
A wash and a wax used to take a lot out of you. But with the new Armor All Gel system, you can wash without a bucket and wax while you dry. Every time. The Armor All Gel system. The simple way to get a wax with every wash.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot! Yeah!
Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, this time start with Right Guard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. Right Guard, start right and right.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Visit ChoiceHotels.com this spring and book a stay at any of these hotels. You'll earn triple Choice Privileges points or triple airline miles. Triple your rewards only at ChoiceHotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
How fast can Allivert start treating an allergy here?
This fast.
And here?
This fast.
Allivert dissolves fast without water. Get non-drowsy allergy relief without a prescription. Allivert. Right when you need it, wherever you are.
I ran the 800. I studied mechanical engineering and industrial design. I was a conference champion. I graduated with a GPA of 3.2. It took hard work, discipline, and stamina. And believe me, I rely on those things every day raising my daughter.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
As a team, Oklahoma State so dominant in this 2005 Division I wrestling with their third consecutive NCAA title. Take a look at our Coca-Cola storyline. Coke in the NCAA, nothing like it. And with 3 straight titles now for John Smith and the Cowboys, they have 33 overall. Iowa's next, by the way. They won 20 team titles in their time so far. So the Cowboys are returning to dominance in NCAA wrestling.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2005 NCAA Wrestling Championships, brought to you by Comfort Inn. New face, same friendly place. Visit choicehotels.com to book. And eLoan. For your next mortgage, home equity, or auto loan, go to eLoan.com.
Patriots fans, your team just won the Super Bowl. And now you can own the Patriots Championship DVD. Relive the highlights from every game of the Patriots' amazing season right through their Super Bowl 39 victory. Call 1-877-NFL-DVDS and own a piece of Patriots history. Get the officially licensed Championship DVD for only $24.99. Call 1-877-NFL-DVDS or go to dvd.nfl.com.
Good morning. At GEICO, we're all about happy customers. In fact, 97% rate our claim service fast and fair. But to get the other 3%, we're going across America, door to door.
Now, of course, I don't want to get too technical, but if you look at the latest customer satisfaction ratings,
those people sure were nice. My hands are still pruny.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I'm not going on stage wearing glasses. I'd rather be up there, blind basically, than have these glasses on. I knew I had to do something.
My friend got Acuvue Advanced Contacts. She looked gorgeous.
Don't they hurt or irritate your eyes or something? Because that's what everybody said.
Trust me, they're different. They have HydroClear. I said, let's go for it. It's so moist. I feel awesome.
For a free trial pair certificate, visit tryacuvue.com.
Lily, I'm home.
What a day.
Three depositions and an emergency brief to file.
And on top of that, I find out that the Tyler estate is leaving everything to their cat.
So, how was your day?
Too busy to meet people? Call It's Just Lunch, dating for busy professionals. We'll personally match you with someone who shares your interests, then make all the arrangements for lunch or drinks after work. No pressure, It's Just Lunch. Call 800-99-LUNCH.
So from the Savas Center in St. Louis, we look at the 285-pound or heavyweight classification and the class we've been looking for with Steve Mocco and Cole Conrad. These guys have been on a collision course, and we are not disappointed. So with Steve Mocco of Oklahoma State looking for his second championship, he won in 2003 while he was with the Iowa Hawkeyes, and Cole Conrad of Minnesota. Of course, Mocco wearing the orange singlet and Cole Conrad in the yellow.
Conrad, the only wrestler that's really challenged Mocco all year. He's wrestled him twice. He's taken him into overtime all the way to the sixth period overtime where Mocco has won.
Pampas Gold 2-disc CD. The DVD contains an additional...
Conrad finished fourth last year. This is Mocco's third final. He lost in the finals as a freshman, took second, won it.
Action, guys,
and now
action,
he has an opportunity
action.
To add a second crown. But, boy, there's some beef up there. Conrad is as big as Mocco. And normally, people are intimidated. Heavyweights are intimidated
center,
by Mocco. Not Conrad.
A couple of years ago, a Minnesota wrestler was wrestling Steve Mocco.
Action,
it would have been a
action.
Big Ten matchup because Mocco was in the Hawkeye uniform and has since transferred, and now his first final
back,
as an
guys.
Oklahoma
back,
State Cowboy.
When I talked to his father, part of the rationale was they wanted a team title as well,
center.
And he felt the transfer to Oklahoma State would give him that.
Get to him.
Action, guys, action!
Moving to go. Conrad with a front headlock attempt to try to drop Mocco down to the mat.
What I like about that is he dictated
right in.
You got Mike on
the pace there. Dictating the action. Got some blood right there. The official Chuck Yagla, a two-time NCAA wrestling champion himself from the University of Iowa back in 75 and 76. And so what better than a top official being also an NCAA champion wrestler?
No Don't forget, coming up next, we bring you the 2005 ISU World Figure Skating Championships presented by Olay, featuring Americans Michelle Kwan and Sasha Cohen. That's coming up right after wrestling.
Hold on, hold on. Okay,
Chuck, wait.
Okay, let's go.
All right, we're ready to go back to action with a minute 25 remaining in the first period.
Conrad not showing any intimidation at all with Mako, really working with him here. Now trying a leg shot, standing single, but doesn't get it.
Action, guys, action!
Mako not only a national junior wrestling champion, but a national junior judo champion.
Guys, when these guys try to grab a leg like that, it's like grabbing a tree trunk.
You gotta uproot it to score.
Sometimes all you gotta do is spin around behind it too.
Keep moving.
You saw Mako had a nice single leg in his one of his matches where low outside turned the corner, the sprawl totally missed him by his opponent, and he's capable of doing it.
Warning both, darling! Warning both!
Wow. You know, the people are booing, but you know what? I think sometimes the referee has to get in. They're just hand fighting. There's nothing going on. Sometimes a double stall is a good call.
I agree with you, Tim. I agree with you. Neither one really. Conrad had that one little snatch single attempt, didn't get it. But really, all they're doing is hand fighting. No real change of levels.
Short time, short.
So 4 seconds remaining in this opening period. It will come to a close with no damage done by either wrestler. We go to Quint Kestnick. Quint?
Green, your choice, guys.
When I spoke with Coach John Smith this week, he says it's been a pleasure to work with Steve Mako. He says Steve's tenacity stands out. He says he demands a great deal from himself. He trains for perfection. He's an absolute ball of intensity. There's only one option for Steve Mako. That's to be the best. He also mentioned that he thought the Olympic red shirt and Olympic experience allowed him to look at areas that needed improvement. He also said the disappointment of that failure is a plus.
Well, you were a part of that, Jeff, and at least a witness to it. Explain what you think Mako learned in the Olympic trials.
Well, certainly you're going to go up against older wrestlers, not just collegians. And when you go up against older wrestlers, you learn a lot more tricks, get a lot more experience. And, of course, the international style, you're not allowed to go anywhere near your back at all or you're scored on it. That can also help because you do moves cleaner that way. But I had never seen Mako take a shot until he was at Oklahoma State.
Well, that's what he's done. He's improved his wrestling because he has actually shown that he can change levels, attack at the legs. He can do an outside sweep. We all knew he had a foot sweep. That was patented. But, man, he can double, he can drop that level now and go.
Mako just had an opportunity there and couldn't capitalize. He had a nice angle. Conrad now in on a good single leg.
Able to escape. Almost for Conrad.
The last 11 years at heavyweight, Minnesota has had 10
action,
All-Americans.
Guys, action! Center!
Garrett, Benjamin, Lowney, Lesnar.
Hustle back, guys. Hustle back. Let's go.
Lesnar, champ.
Come on, guys, in the middle. Action, guys.
Steve Mako, who he's wanted to be a wrestler his whole life. At the age of 5, he actually was sitting in the stands watching his brother wrestle, and he got so upset at his brother's opponent, he came out of the stands, ran in the ring, and grabbed his brother's opponent's ankle. Everybody got a good chuckle out of it because here's this little 5-year-old kid in the ring. He said, Dad, I really want to wrestle. His dad said, when you can do 25 push-ups, you can wrestle. He did it at age 6, and the rest, as they say, is history. Don't forget, coming up next, we're going to bring you the 2005 ISU World Figure Skating Championships featuring Americans Michelle Kwan and Sasha Cohen. That's coming up next here on ESPN right after wrestling.
Another thing about Steve Mako, he can ride. He's done a nice job right here, and there's the difference. Now, In the last two matches, he has used the 30-second ride in the overtime to win the match. Whether he can do it the entire period, still to be seen.
If he can just do it for a little over half the period, that would give him that riding time. Plus, he got the 1 point for the escape earlier.
Conrad really moved well there in that last sequence. See if he can get it going again here. He's looking for hand control. He got it.
Now it's up for grabs again. Still up for grabs.
Third time they've met this year, third time they've been in this position with the clock ticking down and the match all tied up. And that's Mako right there. You talked about it earlier. The time to do the foot sweep is when you catch your opponent coming into you, pushing in. It wasn't quite there. He'd sure like to execute it. But Conrad, too smart.
Nice snap by Conrad, but couldn't get himself out of the way to take advantage of it. It's all about unbalancing, creating angles.
That's why you got to keep moving your feet. Moving your feet, trying to work to improve your tie.
All right, check this out.
7.6 seconds to go in regulation. Looks like we're heading for a sudden victory period. We are.
One minute.
A sudden victory period. And don't forget, coming up next, the 2005 ISU World Figure Skating Championships with Michelle Kwan and Sasha Cohen. That's coming up right after wrestling.
And we talked about at the outset, can Oklahoma State tie the record for most champions in the championship? Five set by Iowa twice in 86 and 97. Mako wins here. Oklahoma State owns a part of that record. There's the foot sweep. There's the foot sweep. There's the foot sweep. He caught him coming in. Hook the ankle down. Patented move.
Used to be his only move.
Steve Mako makes it 5-for-5 for the Cowboys. Wow. A sudden victory for Steve Mako with his patented move. And John Smith hugged for the fifth time tonight. Steve Mako, you talk about a Pontiac high performance moment. This is it for Mako as he wins in the heavyweight division for the second time in his career. We're back with more in just a moment.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
This spring, you don't have to go far to make travel rewarding. Just visit choicehotels.com and book a stay at any of these hotels. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline miles.
I've been everywhere.
Triple your rewards only at choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
Even with good credit, getting a home loan can be a long process. But at eLoan, you apply in just minutes, either online or over the phone. There's a lot less paperwork, and you get a loan decision fast. It's lending the way it was meant to be. Apply now at eLoan.com.
It's turning time at Hooters, and that means the nets are full.
Yeah, looking pretty slick there, Coach.
We've got great basketball action and our finest four seafood menu featuring our easy peel and buffalo shrimp and our new beer battered fish and chips. Register to win a trip to St. Louis for championship basketball with me. So get to Hooters for net time today. Hey, I'm still fishing.
Me too. And I just hooked a largemouth.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot. Yeah!
Hey, maybe it's your deodorant. Let's start over. No, this time start with RightGuard Gel. It's the strongest gel around. RightGuard, start right and right.
So Oklahoma State with their third consecutive NCAA wrestling title. And on top of all that, they had five wrestlers also win individual championships. So congratulations to the Cowboys for a dominating performance. This concludes our coverage from the Savas Center. We hope you've enjoyed the coverage of the NCAA Wrestling Championships. Up next, we bring you the 2005 ISU World Figure Skating Championships. The preceding has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. This weekend, we have asked these great athletes, these warriors, to have the desire to be champions. We certainly haven't been disappointed. Tonight, we crown 10 individual champions and a team champion as well. For the most part, orange was the prominent color. But in a sense, all these competitors are champions. For Jeff Blatnick, Tim Johnson, and Quint Kestnick, this is Dave Armstrong saying so long from St. Louis.
There's more to Moscow than the city. It entices with intrigue, seduces with the suggestion of secrets hidden within. And there's more to judge here than the surface. More to